Now, MLAs in Telangana will soon get luxurious apartments with deluxe facilities in Hyderabad, and the lavish quarters have been built at a whopping 166 crore rupees and will house a gym, a shopping centre and a 12-storey domestic health quarter. On Tuesday, Telangana Assembly Speaker Pocharam Srinivas inspected the newly constructed apartments that will be allotted very soon. My colleague Paul joining me on the story with more. Paul, what we're seeing right now is lavish and very swanky homes for these Telangana MLAs, but one can't help but actually notice how glaring the fact is that no cabinet has been formed as yet.
Well, it's been over a month since KCR Soren as the Chief Minister for the second time of India's youngest state, Telangana. But even now, we don't have a cabinet in place in the state. In fact, MLAs are waiting eagerly to know who will make the mark to form the cabinet, to form the ministers in KCR's cabinet. But however, now the Yagam is going on, 5 days prayers, special prayers before, which will be a prelude before the announcement of the cabinet is what we're hearing. This particular housing complex is in Hyderguda area. It has houses that are almost worth 166 crores. In fact, it's around 2,000 odd square feet. And also domestic health, a 12-story building will be there for them, a shopping complex, like you pointed out, a gym, and all facilities. In fact, the houses will have a visiting room, a three-bedroom house, a kitchen, a sitting area, and also visitors can also use the facilities provided at the bottom of the flat. They have gas connections. All kind of facilities are provided in this. In fact, a committee will be formed to ensure that the right people get this particular house. In fact, all the MLAs, of irrespective of political parties, will be given these. In case an MLA decides to stay in the old quarters, the old MLA quarters that were given to them before, then these...
Paul, I'm sorry to cut you off there, but stay with us. We have Jitendra Reddy, TRS MP, now joining us on the phone line. Sir, good morning. Thank you so much for speaking with Mirror Now. It really appears that there seems to be a bit of a situation of misplaced priorities in Telangana, where cabinet for... where, you know, swanky state-of-the-art homes and yagnas seem to be taking more importance and priority over cabinet formation.
Yeah, definitely. You see, we are a state who does anything in a steady and a proper way. So we are still having much elections, like Gram Panchayat elections are going on. And each and every village people are all involved in the elections. MLAs are involved in the elections. Officers are involved in the elections. So all that priority is being given to that type of... that side of the thing. So, in the meantime, definitely our Chief Minister, who has been very successful for the last 4.5 years in bringing up the newly born state, and you know that we have achieved a 29.1% growth, which no state in the country has got it. So, we are emphasizing and trying to bring in a good cabinet and a strong cabinet to the state of Telangana. And as you know, that these yagnas and all, it is not a new thing for Telangana. We have always done these yagnas so that the mercy of the gods always be with us in Telangana, and have a proper no hurdles, and nobody should have their eye on our Telangana. It should be a proper way we should. That's how the Igna is always being done, and we also thought that if everything goes well for the state, the Igna will be done, and so that is the performing which is happening.
Sir, but don't you think that it is also important that a cabinet is formed in the state, considering it has been over 40 days?
If you leave it to us, now we are doing our administration, nobody is worried about it. Why you people are worried on that? Nobody has complained to you. Nobody has done anything. Everything is going in a very normal way, and it's going in a very good way. I told you that even if it is late, we will come up with a good, strong cabinet.
Stay with us, sir, because we also have Sridhar Reddy from the BJP joining us on the phone line. Good morning. Thank you so much for speaking with Mirror Now. What do you make of the fact that TRS seems to think, and the state of Telangana and the newly elected chief minister seems to think, that it's all right to put yagnas and to put swanky apartments for the MLAs before cabinet formation?
Yeah, yajnas they can do. I mean, he has done many yajnas in the past. But it is personal belief. I mean, nobody is against it because anybody can do yajnas and all that stuff. But as far as the government is concerned, it is not his private property. Rather, there is a constitution in place. Okay, in all the four other states where elections were conducted along with Telangana, the government is in place, cabinet is in place, and proper government is functioning. Only in Telangana, the chief minister doesn't have faith on his colleagues, those who are MLAs, that they can form a stable, they can form an able cabinet. We have only one home minister. Okay, entire cabinet is not filled. There are 17,000 crore bills are pending for the payment in the state, and no ministry is properly functioning because the principal secretaries are running the, you know, particular departments. There is no minister who is elected by the people to review or take, you know, right decisions. So Mr. KCR might be thinking that there is no need of cabinet. Any which way, the cabinet will not be functioning to their decisions, to their freedom. They will be only following the directions of the chief minister. At the same time, we already have a couple of complexes in place in Hyderabad to house the MLAs. What is the urgency to, you know, construct this one, complete this one? And there are also one more complex in the construction in Adarsh Nagar. At the other end, the poor people of Telangana, the common man who is supposed to get the double bedroom house, they are not getting for the last 4.5 years. They have promised more than 2 lakh houses. Hardly they could build some 14,000-15,000 houses. They also have not been completely handed over. The chief minister and his team is hurry completing their Pragati Bhavans, their camp offices, their MLA offices, their, you know, some commercial complexes for the, you know, all other benefits, but not for the poor people. And I am listening to the Honorable MP Jitendra Reddy Garu saying that, you know, who is complaining? Well, nobody will individually come and complain, but the government is not functioning. Where are the ministers? The chief minister will review the irrigation. The chief minister will review the home. The chief minister will review the finance. What is this? I mean, the constitution has to be honored. Nowhere in the country you could see such a inertia in forming the government. What is the hurry placing a home minister? And what is stopping you to, you know, form the other cabinet?
Absolutely, sir. Very pertinent points there being made by the BJP. Mr. Jitendra Reddy, would you like to respond to that, considering there are some very pressing issues that matter at, you know, at hand here, because, you know, there are 33 departments, 289 organizations in the government of Telangana. It is humanly impossible, sir, for one person to make decisions and monitor all their execution.
We have the stamina, we have got the power, we can do it, we can handle it, we are doing it as required by the people. And even today, yesterday on 21st of 2 days back, there was a result given by the panchayat people from the villages, and they have given a bumper results for the supporters of the TRS. So I don't feel anything is there, and if they feel that it is unconstitutional and all, which we know the constitution will read it very well, and we go through each and every paper, each and every act, we know nothing is unconstitutional thing which we have done. Whatever we are doing, it slow and steadily we are doing it. If he is in a hurry, let him go and go on doing it. But this is the way we are going to do our administration.
Right. Mr. Jitendra Reddy, thank you so much. And Mr. Sridhar Reddy of the BJP, thank you so much for speaking with Mirror. Now, let me also bring in my colleague, Paul. Paul, we saw just, you know, a couple of days ago, even the Congress raising the issue, saying, you know, and once again, like the BJP, putting across some very pertinent questions here. The TRS, of course, confident that they can run the state. But there has to be, you know, things that need to be considered, like payment of pensions, electoral promises that are made by the ruling party, gathering information to prepare the budget. So who's looking at all of this currently?
Well, on one hand, when KCR has sweeped the elections in Telangana, political analysts fear that this has got into his head, because this kind of victory wherein, like I said, he swept the elections in total here in Telangana. So we're hoping that this doesn't really get to his head because of two, three things. One is he has the federal front in mind. Secondly, like you said, misplaced priorities. Cabinet doesn't seem to be a priority as of now. Like the TRS MP Jitendra Reddy was pointing out, all the resources, all the state machinery was directed towards the panchayat elections. Hence, a lot of effort was put in to the panchayat elections. So does that mean the state can be ignored? Because cabinet, like I said, 40 days over, but still we don't have a cabinet. Also, another important point that was being raised by the BJP leader, he's saying 2 BHK was the election promise by KCR, which means everyone below the poverty line would be given free two-bedroom houses. But we hardly have any houses here. Around 14,000, like you pointed out, have been constructed. But what about that promise? At the same time, 3 BHK swanky houses for your own legislators. On one hand, TRS is saying that this is required for the development because for legislators to perform well, they need to be given the resources and facilities. Only then they can carry out their duties. On the other hand, people questioning, what about your promises? We have brought you back to power with the hope that you will fulfill those unfulfilled promises which you have taken. You have began in your first regime. So hopefully the 2 BHK promises will also be fulfilled by the government. In the meanwhile, people are waiting for accountability. People are waiting for questions to be answered. Now it's a one-man army in the state of Telangana. KCR is heading it. Like you said, several departments. Work is going on. What some people, supporters of PRS, are saying is that, why do we complain? Work is going on. We don't have any untoward incidents happening.
Right.
No kind of complaints coming forward. But why are we questioning? But it is the right of the people to have a cabinet. It is the right of the people to question the concerned authorities. And for that, we need a cabinet. We need ministers.
Right. Paul, thank you so much for putting that in perspective. No cabinet, but swanky homes for the Telangana MLAs.